Hi students, you have studied science up to class 5th. You know about human beings. Human beings have life as they respire and grow. You also have studied about small plants and big trees. Do you know? Plants also have life like us. Like we respire and grow, they also have the same features like us. They also grow and they also respire like human beings. Today, we are going to study about the life in the plants. We shall study four features of the plants.
Number one. What is growth in the plants? Number two, what is regeneration in the plants? And how regeneration takes place in the plants? Number three, what is response to stimuli in the plants? And how different plants respond to different stimuli? And number four, we shall also study what is respiration in the plant and how does it take place. By observation of few plants in the garden, we can see that there is growth, regeneration, and response to stimuli in the plants, for which we need few plants, beaker, jar, and blowing pipe, etc.
Are you ready to learn today's lesson? Okay, let us start. First of all, we learn what growth in the plant is.
Let us see this. There are seven plants. Do you find any difference in these plants? Yes. First plant is smaller than the second plant, and second plant is smaller than the third plant, and third plant is smaller than the fourth plant, and so on.
Then what we can conclude after observing these plants, we observe that plants also grow like us. Plants also grow like human beings. It means plants also have life like us. If we grow a plant in our house, after few days we see that it has leaves and stems. Again, after few more days, plants will bear fruits and flowers. So we can say that plant also grows. They increase their height like us. They grow their body parts like human beings.
Let us go to a botanical garden.
If we observe a particular plant for few days there and observe that how does it grow, we can observe the following things.
Number one, the number of leaves in the plant multiplies day by day. Number two, its stem increases in length. Number three, after few days, flowers bloom on the plant. Number four, and if we observe the plants for few more days, then the plant will bear fruits also.
Students, do you know there are few animals like lizard, when their any particular body part is destroyed, they are able to regenerate it again. For example, lizard can regenerate its tail again. Regeneration is also one of the features in the plants. Now, let us study this feature of the plants. Can you tell me what regeneration in the plants is? Let us see this picture.
In this picture, you can see a pot in which there is a plant which has only one leaf and a broken branch. After few days, more branches and leaves come out from the plants, and this process goes on. In this, new branches have come in the plant and bud has also become flower. So we can say that there is regeneration and growth in the plant.
This process of coming out of the branches again after the old one is destroyed is called regeneration in the plants. You have understood both the terms growth and regeneration. Let us take third feature which tells us that plants also have life, that is response to stimuli. Students, when we touch some hot object, we immediately remove our hand from that object. By removing our hand from the hot object, we give response to the hot stimuli. Plants also have same feature and this is called response to stimuli. Let us see this.
Students, have you seen touch me not plant? When you touch its leaves shrink. This process of shrinking of leaves is called response. The leaves of this plant are sensitive to touch, so it is called touch me not plant. Let us take another plant. Have you seen Portulaca plant? Its common name is Raat Ki Rani. Do you know Raat Ki Rani? Its flowers bloom at night.
Only during daytime they don't show any response to sunlight, and they keep their petals folded. And when night comes, their petals are opened and its flowers bloom and look beautiful. This is called response to stimuli. It means flowers of these plants are sensitive to light. During night, they give response. We can do one activity at our home for response to stimuli. Take a plant and cover it under a cardboard with hole on one side of the cardboard. After few days, due to stimuli, plant bend towards the light, that is towards the hole from which light is coming in the cardboard. This is also response to stimuli. Let us take one more example. Sunflower plant responds to stimuli during daytime only. We see that its flowers and leaves keep bending towards the sun. This is also called response to stimuli. Our last feature is respiration. Like living organism breathe, and during breathing they take oxygen and release carbon dioxide. Plants also do the same thing. Now in this feature we are going to discuss the process of respiration in the plants. Let us discuss one activity first. Take two small plants in pot A and pot B and follow the following steps. Keep the pot A in sunlight or open. Keep the pot B under a vacuumed jar for 1 week. And see. After 1 week, we observe that the plant in the pot A is green. The plant in the pot B is about to die. Now remove the jar from the pot B also, and observe the plant for 2 or 3 days. The plant B becomes green again, which was about to die under the jar. This shows that plants also need air to breathe. Under the jar, it was not able to get air to breathe. It means that plants also respire like human beings. And now let us discuss how the process of respiration takes place. Take a pot with a plant, see its leaves from both the sides. You can see small holes in it. Through these holes, plants take oxygen, and in these holes, there is an exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide. It is a complex process and called respiration in the plants. By another activity, Let us prove that plants release carbon dioxide during respiration. We all know that lime water turns milky due to carbon dioxide. When we blow in the lime water, it turns milky due to the carbon dioxide present in our breath. It means that lime water turns milky due to the carbon dioxide. Plants also leave carbon dioxide. We take 2 beakers. In beaker A, put some soaked black gram seeds. In beaker B, put some boiled black gram seeds and cover both the jars. Keep 4 days. After 4 or 5 days, put some lime water in both the jars and observe. What we see is that in beaker A, lime water turns milky. In beaker B, lime water does not turn milky. In beaker A, lime water turns milky because seeds were germinating in this and were in the process of becoming plant. There was respiration process going on and it released carbon dioxide which turned the lime water milky. Number one, there is growth. Number two, they can regenerate their parts. Number three, plants respond to stimuli. Number four, plants breathe or respire, so they are living organism. All these features show that plants have life because they have growth, regeneration, response to stimuli and respiration like any other living being. So we can say that plants also have life like human beings. In the last section, we have self-check exercise for you. Now try this exercise.